Howdy, howdy, howdy. I am coming to you live here on the Facebooks and wanted to, let me back out my camera. Good grief. It looks like I'm just eating up. All right, here we go. Oh yeah. Look here. Got the raw dog wiener shirt on, plump and juicy in your mouth. Raw dog wieners, 25 cent. Our meat can't be beat. All right. So, this question has come up lately a bunch. It's because it's that time of year and a lot of people are new people coming in and going, oh my gosh, hey, Tony, glad you're here, brother. New people coming in and going, what do I do? What do I say to get a commissary? Well, you know, I have this in the free training section at learnhotdogs.com, but I wanted to read this script to you that I wrote, and it's on page 44 of Look here, Hot Dogs Save My Life, the course book, okay? Most comprehensive course book on the planet, okay? You can get that, by the way, at learnhotdogs.com/book. That's it. And you read a free chapter before you go into it. Just read a free chapter and check it out, okay? Hey, good day, Dave. David, the lunch pad's here. David Unito's here. Glad y'all are here with me. If you want to say hi, just type it in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. Daniel says he loves my shirt. Thank you, Daniel. I like it too. One of my daughters got it for me and I appreciate it. But I'm going off of page 44 and I'm going to read the script. Now, a lot of you may be watching this going, what in the heck is commissary? Commissary is a fancy, Egyptian hieroglyphic name for a commercial kitchen. Not really, but that is the meaning. It's a commercial kitchen. It's a commercially licensed kitchen. That's all it is. Okay. And I go into this on how to get them and the alternatives to getting them. And I've even updated it and there's even more, but, a common way, okay, is to find somebody with a restaurant, somebody with a gas station that has a grill inside. You know, some gas stations that like mom and pop gas stations have, they do biscuits and gravy in the morning. One right down the street from me does biscuits and gravy every morning. Right. So you can go and ask them, well, how do you ask? Like, what would you say? And I want to read this to you. Hey, Bubba Mason. I got to put that up. Bubba says, ordering your book in about an hour. So excited. Glad you are. Go read a free chapter, though, at learnhotdogs.com/book. And I'm glad you get it. Yeah, verse 3. Mark says verse 3, chapter 44, verse 3. All right, so here's the deal, okay? You get a commissary, it feels awkward, and a lot of people are like, oh, I don't want to ask somebody if I can use it. I want you to hear how easy this is. This isn't a hard quest, okay? And now there's alternatives to it. In case you just don't want to do it, a lot of cities have what they call incubator kitchens, and you can just go pay. But I like getting them free, okay? And I want to tell you something. My script is, hello, Mr. and Miss Commercial Kitchen or whatever. If you happen to know them, that's even better, okay? But and let me preempt this by saying, never, ever do this, ever, ever do this on the phone. Unless you know them like this and you saw them at church Sunday twice and you know, there's no reason to call on the phone. If you want to know, that's how you get one, is call on the phone. It's better to walk in there, go, here's a picture, here's our business card, or here's our flyer, even if you don't have business cards, but there's no sense in not having business cards because Vistaprint, you can get business cards for like $5, okay? Get you a business card. But you walk in there, hand them your business card, your flyer, whatever. Here's a picture of our cart, maybe even if it's on your cell phone. My wife and I just starting a hot dog cart and vending cart and maybe a catering company. And we have to have a commercial kitchen. Well, we're just getting started and the state requires us to have one. Now, even though we just buy our product as we go and you'll probably never see us, we still have to have one because they want to ensure that if we buy 400 pounds of potatoes, we got a place to put it, and the place to put it is in a commercial kitchen. Would you allow us to list you as our commercial kitchen? Now, the first place I went to was a friend, kind of. You know, we were pretty close, not like best friends. We didn't like go bowling together or hunting together or anything, but we were friends. We knew each other. And he goes, my business is crowded, but you ain't going to be here really? I said, yeah, I'll probably never be here. I mean, it may happen where I need to come in and do some, you know, stuff, but rarely. And he goes, go ahead, put me down, sign me up. And then I give him this little commissary letter that says they gave me permission. Some states don't require that. If you're looking for that commissary letter, they're free on our blog. They're free on the hot dog page, on the hot dog cart store page. You can just go and get that commissary letter, download it, print it off, and walk in there and do your little spiel. And I'm going to read you exactly what I said, though. Hello, Mr. and Miss Commercial Kitchen Owner. Replace that with their names. My name is Ben. My wife and I have recently purchased a small hot dog cart, and we're going to be doing catering and stuff with it. And we, so that we can make a living. The state of Tennessee requires that I have access to a commercial kitchen for food prep and storage. However, because we plan on buying our products from the supermarket as needed, we don't prep anything. You would probably never see us. Either way, the state requires that I find someone willing to give me permission to come in during your hours. I won't mess up your hours, won't come in when you're busy and slammed or anything like that. And clean my pans or prep foods. Will you consider signing this commissary agreement so that I can get to work? Most of them will say yes. Okay. I had a customer call. They weren't even a customer of mine. They were just a vendor. They had found a cart somewhere that didn't buy it from me. And they called into the radio show and they wanted help getting a commissary. And they said they had run into no, everywhere. And I said, where'd you go? You know, and they didn't want to go through all that. And so I said, I'll call you, you know, or you can call me, you know, after the show. Well, they called me after the show. I took the details down. Make a long story short, out of the three places they gave me that they went, I talked to the manager at two of those places they had never been. They had never asked, unless both those managers were lying. Could have been, probably not, but could have been, right? Benefit of the doubt. But the other place said, yeah, I got a call from some lady who wanted to use our kitchen. A call? She said she went in there. She didn't go in there. So bottom line is, I helped her get a commissary, and I had to call because she was in another state. I had to call. And so I did my call, did my little, I said, listen, single mom, she really needs help. You'll probably never see her, but she needs to have one. Yeah. First one. Boop. Took it. Right. I was good to go. So, that's how easy it is. By the way, that's on page 44 of Hot Dog Save My Life book. I don't know if you can see that. There it is. Hot Dog Save My Life course book. This is not a story book. It's not like poor, poor, pitiful Ben. Read this story before you go to bed, make you real sleepy. No, this is all the nuts and bolts to get you started and get you started right. I want to read you something. I want to read you something because if you don't have this book, there's people here I know, and I'm fixing to post up their stuff, their comments. I'm gonna post them on the screen so you can see them. But there's people here that have read this and know. Okay, but you can go. I'm going to read, let me find this real quick. Bear with me. I'm looking. Don't think I'm ignoring you. I'm not. Okay. Here you go. Here's somebody who read the book. Hello, Ben. This I got 21 hours ago, and he gave me permission to read this or post it up, okay? 21 hours ago, so that's 7:33 p.m. last night I got this email. I haven't been in a hurry to get going. Rather, the start till now process has been a family learning together experience. Not a hobby, but a project for us to handle together from start to finish. The time we've been researching and pulling together the knowledge we've needed has been almost a year now. I loved every minute of it, and it has cracked the plaque off our brains. So now I decided to purchase your book. And in immediate order, I realized that my months of prep and study could have been reduced to days. Other than the benefits of practicing my reading skills, I can't see any situation why anyone should start with reading, shouldn't start with reading your book and getting on to watching your videos. In 11 months, nothing gave me the, and he puts it in quotes, we finally got this feeling until taking the time to learn from a pro. That comes from Wade. Wade, if you're listening, I appreciate it for even letting me use that testimonial. But I wanted you to know. So where do you go to get it? LearnHotDogs.com/book. LearnHotDogs.com/book. Grab you a free chapter. Okay? Try it out for size. See if it feels good. Right? Now, for those that are Vendors United members, okay? Oh, by the way, I'm going to give, when you get a book, you're going to get free 5-day trial into the members area. But for the members, guess what we finally got? We finally nailed down a time and date once a week for the live one-on-one with all these street food pros in our private member area. Okay? It starts tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern. You can go over to the special page. You'll see it, okay, in your members area. So we're excited. We'll have that out. If you can't make it, no worries. But we already know we're going to be discussing tonight with Mark Lawler. We're going to be discussing doing a hot dog eating competition, the risks, the rewards, and maybe getting people to sign off on, you know, a waiver saying when I choke and die, I can't sue you kind of thing. We're going to talk about that stuff. We're going to have fun tonight. It's going to be awesome. Now, I want to go through some of these comments real quick. Let's see here. Tony says, hello, Ben. Howdy. Dave, the lunch pad. David Unito, Mark Lawler. Hey, Ben, love the shirt. Thank you, Daniel. Big Mike, dog hat. Mike Barker in the house, dog house. Hello, everyone. David South Dogs. Anthony says, second of four hot dog inspection on Friday. Getting closer. Finally got the hot water heater installed. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I can't wait to see you start. Bubba Mason, ordering your book in about an hour. That's awesome, Bubba. You're going to love it. I know you will. Mark Lawler from the book of the hot. Let's see. Howdy. Eddie says, howdy. Hello from Collinsville. Jeff says, hey. Hey, Jeff. I'm glad you're here, brother. Dave the Lunchpad. Bubba, you can't go wrong with this book. Daniel Kinney, I'm building a cart right now. Any ideas on the top? I was thinking for Micah. Yes, I got a great idea. Go, I wouldn't go for mica, okay? Go with plywood. You can seal plywood to meet all 50 states' codes. You can use wood, okay? It's just got to be non-porous top and food safe. They make polyurethanes that are food safe. You ever been to a bar and eaten or a restaurant, like especially our barbecue restaurants, that's wood slab? You know, some of them are plywood tables from Lowe's. And then got polyurethane over it, you're good to go, right? So, yes, absolutely yes. So now Formica is expensive. I don't know that I'd add the weight. Formica's heavy. Stainless steel ain't as heavy. You can go get stainless steel, okay? Cut. Go to, let me tell you this real quick, Daniel. Go to a heating and air company, call one and say, who does your custom joints and pipe that you need for, who's your steel fabrication place? And they'll go, oh, that's Bob down there at Bob's Steel Fabrication Shop. Call Bob up and go, Bob, I need a top to fit here. And that way you could still put plywood down, but you could use a thinner plywood because you won't want the added weight. You don't want to go with 3/8 or something. Because then you're going to use 304 grade stainless, and they'll bend the corners. They'll cut your holes where you want them. And literally in a couple hours, they can have that cut out for you and hand you a piece that will fit down over top. And then you can rivet it or screw it in on the sides, depending on your state codes. Most of them allow the screws as long as you put food safe caulk over each head so that it doesn't hold bacteria. Okay. So, Fred's here. Fred, thanks for being here. The lunch pad just shows us a hot dog. I like that. The lunch pad's, I think, in South Florida near Cape Canaveral. And I love that name. I love his, logo a lot. Got a location. Just need a cart. Absolutely, Bubba. There's tons of ways to get a cart. Just had a guy get one for $1,200. Yesterday morning, got a call. Yesterday morning, early. Guy found a used car. He was excited as heck. It wasn't one of my carts, but it was a dang good deal. No matter what, it was a dang good deal. You can get stainless steel sheets, Fred just said, from Amazon. You can get them, but honestly, you can go get it way cheaper because they buy it in huge sheets. Like, they buy it in 4x12 sheets, 4 foot wide, 12 foot high. They'll cut you a section, bend it, fold it, break. They call it a break, a stainless steel break, a metal break, and it bends it where you want it. It cuts the holes out. If they have a plasma cutter or a water jet cutter, they'll cut it out, sand it smooth, hand you a piece that you can set down. It's perfect. Go that route. My pizza guy let me use his kitchen. Freaking awesome. See? It's not that bad. Daniel, anything non-porous, even bar top epoxy? Yes, Dave. Thanks for the tip for him. Here's a free commissary agreement you can download. Look who's here. Heather is in the house. Thank you, Heather. The force is strong with you, Dave says. Bar top epoxy, didn't think of that. Thanks, Dave. Yes, bar top epoxy is great. Great. You know, it's usually a two-part epoxy. Mix it, put it on, dries. Usually takes about 48 hours to cure completely if it's thick. But I can give you some cool ideas. Okay, I can give you some cool ideas. If you're going to use the epoxy, put you some pictures down. Put you some pictures of hot dogs and stuff down and then epoxy over them. Put you some quarters or a wooden nickels or maybe some of those dollar bill pieces or maybe a dollar in there. Our first dollar, and put it underneath the epoxy. Okay. Have somebody pay you a dollar. Get your wife to pay you a dollar for a hot dog and tell her it'll be delivered later on your first day of business. Put that as your first dollar and under your epoxy. It'll just be sexy. I'm telling you. Great book. Got it. Lots of goodies. Ben Dean. Thank you, Ben, for the kind words. Ben, will you autograph my book if I send it to you? Absolutely. I will autograph your book. I don't know what that'd be worth, about less than a half of a cup of coffee. But I'd be happy to do it. Pleasure to be all mine. Dave, the lunch pad. Hey, Ben, I'm chasing you. I'm down 38 pounds since New Year's. Holy moly. Congratulations, Dave. Freaking yes. That makes me happy. I'm happy for you. Said that we can't sell chili and hot cheese on the cart in Memphis, Tennessee. Guess what, Tyrone? If you read my book, I can't either. Okay. But I figured out little loopholes. Catering, private events, do anything you want. But working the street, working in front of the Piggly Wiggly, working in front of Tractor Supply, the co-op, the used part place, we have U-Pullet parts and all those places. Yeah, I can't do it, right? Can't do it. I can sell, yes, you can, Tyrone, you can sell chili, but it has to be vegetarian chili. And you can get that mixed and make it yourself, okay? And I'll buy what you don't use if you don't like it. I'll swear to you, Chili Man, and they don't pay me a dime. Chili Man's chili, they used to make the big cans of it. Now they don't. Don't know why. But I even have in my book that you can get the big cans from them. You can't. They quit. But you can get the packets, make it yourself. It was too cost prohibitive for them to sell the big cans. They didn't have a distribution network. They have won three world records for chili cook-offs with a vegetarian chili you can't tell doesn't have meat. It's that good. You get a little dab on your forehead and your tongue will beat your brains out trying to get to it. So check it out. Let's see. Rednecks Concession in Canada. Wayne, I didn't know we had rednecks in Canada, but welcome to the club, brother. Glad you're here. Baseball cards for epoxy top. Yeah. That'd be a cool way to go. Especially whatever, if you have a theme, why not add that into your epoxy? Love these live feeds. Always learn something new, Chris. I do too. I'm having a blast doing them. I can't wait for our first live one where people can join us. Like people listening, like y'all in the Vendors United tonight can actually join in and be on the screen with me and it's going to be fun. How much money and change should I bring for a setup? Let me tell you, Fred, I just did a video the other day on this, I think a couple weeks ago, but let me tell you real quick. Okay. I like to have at least 100, but a good number is $200. Okay. I like to have about 120s and then 50 in 10s and 50. Let me take that back. 40 in 10s Okay. Then I like to have at least 40 in ones. Okay. And then fives, the remaining. I think that was 20, according to my math. I'm not always good at that. Third grade was rough a couple years. All right. So that's it. All I'm telling you, if you want to read a free chapter or you want to grab the book at the lowest price I've ever had it for, go to learnhotdogs.com/ book, B-O-O-K. Learnhotdogs.com/book, grab it. And I'm going to even give you a free, okay, entry into a 5-day trial into the street food protein. It's a private group. You don't have to stay, leave, okay? But tonight, if you did this on your 5-day trial, you could be watching with us and joining in with us with the street food pros. You're talking people that are doing kick butt, okay, here. And I'm glad you came. And I'll be back tomorrow with something else. I usually just do it by questions. You know, if a bunch of questions come in that are similar, I'll do a live thing. Y'all have a good one. I'll talk to you later.